take that shape.
அதே பக்கம் பாட்டு டாப் மெயின்
Okay. Good morning, students. So in last class we are discussing the interactional part of the polynomials. Now we are going to discuss another topic in polynomials. So chapter 2, polynomials.
See?
Chapter 2, polynomials. So now already we know that in a linear polynomial, the number of zeros of the linear polynomial is, the number of zeros of the linear polynomial is 1, and the number of zeros of the quadratic polynomial is 2, the number of zeros of the cubic polynomial is 3, and the number of zeros of biquadratic polynomial is 4. Now we are going to discuss about a relationship between zeros and coefficients. Zeros and coefficients of the polynomial. Here you can see now. Actually, you can write what is a quadratic polynomial? Ax square plus bx is c. This is the quadratic polynomial. We know very well. So this is the standard form of the quadratic polynomial. Here you can assume that alpha and beta are two roots of this polynomial. Two roots. Alpha and beta are the two roots of this polynomial. Then you can write as x minus alpha and then x minus beta. X minus alpha and x minus beta. Suppose if you are getting 2 is a 0 of the polynomial, then you can write it as minus 2. So why? Because here you can see now, alpha minus 2 is equals to, suppose x minus alpha equals to 0, x equals to alpha. So that's why alpha, here positive alpha I am taking and positive beta. You can write it as x minus alpha and x minus beta. X minus alpha equals to 0, x equals to alpha. So that's why you can write as x minus alpha and x minus beta. These two are the factors of the this polynomial. So these two are the factors. Factors of this polynomial is x minus alpha and x minus beta. Is it clear? Now you can multiply these two polynomials. X into x, x squared, x into minus beta, minus x beta, minus alpha into x, minus x alpha, minus into minus plus, you can write it as plus alpha beta, alpha beta. Here you can write it as x square minus from these two minus x common, you can write as alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. Is it clear? You can write it as alpha beta. Now, so finally we are getting ax square plus bx plus c is equals to x square minus x into alpha plus beta plus alpha beta. Is it clear? So here you can assume k is an any constant. Here you can write, you can multiply with k. K is an any constant. So here you can write now, k is any constant. Any constant. Is it clear? K is an any constant. Here you can see, now you can compare. You can write this one. Now you can multiply with k. Kx square minus kx into alpha plus beta plus k alpha beta. So this side you can write same as is ax square plus bx. Now you can compare x square term and x square term. X square, ax square is equals to kx square. X square, x square get cancelled. A equals to k. A equals to k. Then comes to, we compare bx is equals to minus kx into alpha plus beta. Xx get cancelled. So b by minus k is equals to alpha plus beta. Alpha plus beta. Now a equals to k. A equals to k. Now we can write as minus b by a is equals to alpha plus beta. This is one of the important formula, and then this one is also one of the important formula. So here you can observe. Now you can compare third one. C equals to k alpha beta. C equals to k alpha beta. Instead of k, you can write a. C equals to A alpha beta. Now you can say C by A is equals to alpha beta. C equals to alpha beta. Is it clear? So now here finally we can write, this is the, these two are the roots. Alpha, I mean according to our assumption, alpha and beta are the two roots. Alpha and beta are the two roots. Now alpha and beta are the two roots only. Now you can write it as sum of roots is equals to, sum of the roots equals to alpha plus beta equals to, here you can write alpha plus beta, sum of roots alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a, minus b, minus x coefficient by, a means x square coefficient, coefficient of x by coefficient of x square, minus b by a. Now product of roots, product of roots alpha beta equals to this one, product of roots alpha plus beta equals to c by a. Here suppose in case are you clear this one? Yes, very good. So in case, simply they are given the root instead of alpha equals to 1, beta equals to 2, you can find the quadratic polynomial by using these two roots. Is it clear now? So suppose, are you clear about this one? How to find sum of zeros of the polynomial, quadratic polynomial? How to find product of zeros of the quadratic polynomial? So now you can see, Nana. Suppose, example, alpha, I mean, here you can see, in what code 2, example, find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. Find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial x square plus 7x plus 10. X square plus 7x plus 10, and verify. The relationship between zeros and coefficients. Zeros and coefficients. So here you can first of all you can find the zeros of this quadratic polynomial. How we can find that? By using factorization method. Already you know very well in the 7th class onwards, 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th, now 10th, x square plus 7x plus 10. First of all, you can multiply these two terms. You can multiply these two terms. X square into 10, 10x square. Now, you can write it as 5x into 2x. Now, sum of these two terms is 7x only. Sum of these two terms, 5x into 2x equals to 10x square. Now 5x plus 2x equals to 7x. Now you can split this middle term as 5x plus 2x. Now you can write on x square plus 5x plus 2x plus 10. Is it clear? Now from these two, what is the common number? X is common, x plus 5 plus 2. Again x plus, you are getting x plus. These two are zeros, so that implies. So x plus, here x plus 5 is common, then you can write it as x plus. Now what are the factors? These two are the factors. We need to calculate the zeros. That implies here you can write p of x. So p of x is equals to. Now these two are roots, means these two are the zeros. So that implies x plus 5 is equals to 0. And then x plus 2 is equals to 0. X plus 5 equals to 0. X plus 2 equals to 0. X equals to minus 5. X equals to minus 2. That implies here you can assume that alpha equals to one of the root, you can assume it as minus 5. And beta equals to minus 2. Alpha equals to minus 5. Beta equals to minus 2. Now, what is that question? Find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial. Zeros are computed. One of the root alpha equals to minus 5 and beta equals to minus 2. Now what is this alpha, beta, gamma, delta, whatever it may be? These are Greek alphabets. These are Greek alphabets. So we are using as something like ABC. Now second part. And verify the relationship between zeros and coefficients. Verify the relationship between zeros and coefficients. Already we know that this is quadratic polynomial. First of all, you can find this is which type of polynomial, quadratic, cubic, or whatever it may be. This is quadratic polynomial. Why? Because its highest degree is 2. So now you can compare the relationship between zeros and coefficients. Now, sum of zeros. Here you can write now x square plus 7x plus 10. This is a given polynomial. Now sum, this is here you can write ax square plus bx plus c. Now here you can write sum of zeros. Sum of zeros. What is our sum of zeros formula? Alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a. Alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a. Already we are getting alpha value how much? Minus 5. Beta value plus minus 2 is equals to b value means 7 minus 7 by a value 1, nothing but 1. Now minus 5 minus 2 minus 7 is equals to minus 7. Yes, verify. Now comes the product of zeros. Product of zeros equals to alpha beta, product of zeros, alpha beta equals to c by a. Product of zeros equals to c by a. What is c value? 10. So that's it. I mean, alpha beta, how much? Minus 5 into minus 2 is equals to 10 by 1. Then you can multiply minus into minus plus 10 equals to 10. Yes, verify. This one is also verified. Is it clear? First of all, once again I want to explain this one. First of all, you can identify this is quadratic polynomial, cubic polynomial, or linear polynomial, or biquadratic polynomial, whatever it may be. First of all, you can find which type of polynomial this one. After that, second step is you find the zeros of the polynomial. Find the zeros of the polynomial. Here you can find the zeros of the polynomial. Why? Because by factorization, why? Because it is a quadratic polynomial. We know very well how to find the zeros of this quadratic polynomial. You know very well in 8th, 9th classes. Now comes to the after finding the zeros of the polynomial, you are getting in this problem, you are getting alpha equals to minus 5 and beta equals to minus 2. So now completed. After this part completed, inverse. Now verify the relationship between zeros and coefficients. So already we know that given quadratic polynomial is this. Now you can write it as ax square plus bx plus c form. Now already we know that sum of zeros of the quadratic polynomial formula. What is that? Alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a. Alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a. What is alpha value? Minus 5. Beta value? Minus 2. Here you can substitute. After that, product of zeros. You know the product of zeros. So the alpha beta equals to c by a. And LHS equals to, we are getting LHS equals to RHS. Now verify, already we verify. Okay? Clear? Okay, now I am going to explain next problem. Same problem, same problem. Example 3. Find the zeros of the polynomial. And verify the relationship between x square minus 3 and verify the relationship between zeros and coefficients. Here you can see, first of all here you can identify the polynomial is which kind of polynomial. This is a quadratic polynomial. Why? Because what is its degree? 3. So degree is 3. Then first of all you can write, so given polynomial is P of x is equals to x square minus 3. Here you can observe x square minus 3. Now we are finding the factors of any. We are finding by using this polynomial, we are finding the factors of this polynomial. So here you can see now this one is a square minus b. So a square minus b. Now you can write the root 3, p equals to root 3 whole square. Is it clear? Root 3 whole square. Here I am going to write p of x is equals to x square minus root 3 whole square. Now here you can observe a square minus b square. This is in the form of a square minus b square. Already you know this one. Now you can apply a plus b into a minus b, x plus root 3 into x minus a plus b into a minus b. A square minus b square is equals to a plus b into a minus b. A plus b into a minus b. Now here you can apply ma. So x plus root 3 into x minus root 3. So p of x is equals to 0. That implies now you can apply x plus root 3 is equals to 0 and x minus root 3 is equals to 0. Now x equals to minus root 3 and x equals to root 3. Now you can assume this alpha equals to minus root 3, beta equals to root 3. Alpha equals to minus root 3, beta equals to plus root 3. Is it clear? Okay, we find alpha and beta. Now we need to compare the relationship between zeros and coefficients. Now ax square, I mean, what is that polynomial? X square minus 3. Here you can write ax square. There is no b. There is no b. So that's why you can write as plus bx plus 0x, 0 into x plus minus 3. So ax square plus bx plus c. Is it clear? Now you can compare the sum of roots equals to alpha plus beta is equals to minus b by a. Now you can compare what is alpha value. Alpha equals to minus root 3, beta equals to plus root 3. Is it clear? Now alpha value how much? Minus root 3 plus root 3 is equals to minus b by a. What is b value? 0. 0 by 1. Nothing but a 0. Minus root 3 plus root 3, 0 equals to 0. Yeah? Sum of roots completed. Then comes the product of roots. Product of roots is equals to alpha beta equals to, we know very well, c by, you know very well, c by a. So what is c value? I mean alpha beta equals to minus root 3 into root 3. So that's equals to 3 by 1. So 3 equals to, sorry, minus 3 equals to minus 3. Is it clear? Is it clear one? Minus 3 equals to minus 3. So in this manner, you can find the zeros of the polynomial. And then after that, after finding that zeros of the polynomial, you can find the, verify that, you can verify the relationship between zeros and coefficient. Is it clear, students? Yes. Next alternate method ma, next example 4. Example 4 ma. So here you can see, find the quadratic polynomial. One more important method ma, another method, important method. So find quadratic polynomial. Sum of and product of two zeros are, two zeros are, sum and product of two zeros are minus 3 and 2 respectively. Here you can see now. So find a quadratic polynomial. We need to find a quadratic polynomial. We need to find a quadratic polynomial. So sum and product of two zeros are, I mean sum of zeros equals to sum of zeros alpha plus beta equals to much minus 3. Alpha plus beta equals to minus 3. And then product of roots. Product of roots. Nothing but zeros. Both are equal on alpha beta equals to alpha beta equals to. Now here you can find the quadratic polynomial. Quadratic polynomial means, already we know that k into x square minus alpha beta, alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. This is the formula, direct formula. So k into x square minus alpha plus beta into x plus alpha beta. Here you can already be completed, we find already according to the problem they are given. K into, you can write as x square, there is no x value, x square minus alpha plus beta minus 3 into x plus alpha beta. Is it clear now? So k into x square plus 3x plus x square plus 3x plus 2. Here you can, k is an any constant, here you can substitute k equals to 1, a equals to 1. So that implies 1 into anything, same thing only, na? X square plus 3x plus, this is the quadratic polynomial. This is the required quadratic polynomial. Is it clear now? So here you can observe. So they are given sum and product of two zeros. Sum and product of zeros. In case they are given, I mean, zeros are minus 3 and minus 2. Then same formula. But we need to calculate alpha plus beta, sum of roots and product of roots. Now, can you able to find this? This one is alpha plus beta. This one is alpha beta. Can you able to verify the zeros and zeros and coefficients? Now we need to verify the zeros and coefficients. So that means what is our quadratic polynomial? X square plus 3x plus 2. This is our quadratic polynomial. And then roots. Sum of roots how much? Sum of roots is equals to, according to problem they are given minus 3, but we know that formula is minus 3 by. Minus 3 is equals to ax square plus bx plus c. So that means what is b value? Minus 3 by 1. So minus 3 is equals to, clear? Now comes to the product of roots. Product of roots is equals to c by a. Product of roots equals to c by a. What is c value? 2. 2 equals to 2 by 1. So that implies 2 equals to. Like this, you can able to solve the remaining problems. Is it clear? Now, one more important problem. Here you can see one. Work out 2.2, second row one. Work out 2.2, first row one. Here, can I start work out? 2.2. Work out 2.2. First problem, find the zeros of the quadratic polynomial and verify the relationship between zeros and coefficient. First one is x square minus 2x minus 8. First one, x square minus 2x minus x square minus 2x minus 8. First of all, we need to find zeros of the polynomial. First of all, we need to find the zeros of the polynomial. So that implies you can factorize this one. 8x square, that means 4x into 2x minus 4x into 2x equals to minus 8x square. Is it clear? Now you can write this x square minus 4x plus 2x minus 8. So here x is common, x minus 4. Here plus 2 is common, x minus 4. Sorry, p of x is equals to, you can write that. So p of x is equals to. So that implies p of x is equals to, here x minus 4 is common, so x plus 2. So these two are the factors, that means 0 of the polynomial, 0 is equals to x minus 4, 0 is equals to x plus 2. Now x is equals to 4, x is equals to minus 2, alpha equals to 4 and then beta equals to minus 2, alpha equals to 4 and beta equals to minus 2. Now you compare relationship between zeros and coefficients. What is the given polynomial? X square minus 2x minus 8. Here you can write ax square plus bx plus c. Now already we know that what is that sum of zeros of the polynomial? Sum of zeros equals to minus b by a. Sum of zeros equals to minus b by a. Sum of zeros means alpha plus beta is equals to minus b by a. So what is alpha? 4, beta minus 2. 4 minus 2 is equals to minus b minus 2 by a 1. So okay, can you able to find the remaining answers, remaining problem? So now I am going by another problem. Now you can find the remaining, that's remaining answer. You can substitute that remaining values. Is it clear? You can refer the remaining relationships. Now next problem, 4s square minus 4s plus 1. 4 x square minus 4s plus 1 minus 4s plus 1. S here, s is variable. So that implies, first of all, you can multiply these two over s square. Now 2s into 2s, how much? 4s. So minus 3s into minus, minus into minus, plus 4s square minus 2s minus 2s plus 1. This is p of x is equals to, so p of x is equals to, here 2s is common, 2s is common, here 3s is, from these two terms 2s is common, then 2s minus 1 minus, here 1 common, so 2s minus 1. So therefore again here 2s minus 1 is common, 2s minus 1 is common, so here we can write 2s minus 1. 2s minus 1 and 2s minus 1. Sorry for the disturbance. So now p of x is equals to 2s minus 1 and then 2s minus 1. Here 0 you can substitute. 2s minus 1 equals to 0. 2s minus 1 equals to 0. S is equals to 1 by 2. Same s is equals to 1 by 2. So this is alpha and this is beta. Can you able to find that, verify the relationship now? So here you can see sum of zeros. Sum of zeros is equals to minus b by a. Sum of zeros is equals to minus b by a. That means s, how much nana? 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is equals to minus b by a. Minus b by minus of minus 4 by a value 4. So that means what is the LCM here? 2. So that means 1 plus 1 is equals to 4 by 4. So 2 by 2 is equals to 4 by 4. 1, 1, 1, 1. So that's 1 equals to 1. Is it clear now? Similarly, product of rows, alpha beta equals to c by a, product of rows, 1 by 2 into 1 by 2 is equals to c by a, c value 1, a value 4, 1 by 4. So 1 by 2, 1 by 4 is equals to 1. Like this, you can solve the remaining problems of this workflow. Is it clear? Now, I am going to, you have any doubts means, I posted in this my WhatsApp number, so I will explain same thing, whatever it may be, no problem students. So I think, I hope you all are understood these problems. So these polynomials is are very easy to solve. Here only concentration is, your concentration on variable, mainly your concentration is on variable, so then you are getting the answers. Okay. Now I am going to explain one more problem in that one. So t square minus 15. T square minus 15. T square minus 15. Like this, we have already completed example problem. X square minus 3. So here you can, p of x is equals to t square minus 15. So now you can write p of x is equals to t square minus root 15 whole square. T square minus root 15 whole square. Now, so p of x is equals to t square minus, I mean, this one is a square minus b square. Now you can write it as t plus root 15 and t minus root 15. T plus root 15 and t minus root 15. Now you can write it as 0 equals to t plus root 15 and then 0 equals to t minus root 15. Finally, we are getting t equals to root 15 and t equals to, this one is plus, this one is minus, t equals to root 15. This one is alpha and this one is beta. Now you can verify the relationship between zeros and coefficients. Alpha plus beta equals to minus b by a. What is alpha? Root 15 minus root 15 plus root 15 is equals to minus b by a. There is no b value. This is ax square plus bx plus c. There is no b value. So that implies you can write as 0. So minus root 15 plus root 15, 0 equals to 0. And then product of roots alpha beta equals to c by a. What is c value? Minus 15. By 1 means? So minus root 15 into root 15 is equals to minus 15. Now root 15 into root 15, 15 minus 15 is equals to minus. Is it clear? Now you have any doubts, it goes to my personal number, WhatsApp number, or whatever it may be. So now I am going to end my session. As students, I hope you all are understood. So thank you.